Hey YouTube, welcome to Comics and Stuff. Happy Friday. Hope everybody's doing okay. Thanks for tuning back in. I do apologize for missing last Friday. I was on vacation. If you followed me on Instagram, at Comics and Stuff 1, you'd see that. I'll put a link down in the description below. But anyhow, that's it. And then quick thing, if you guys hear a little background noise, that is because we are currently, I currently have a fan on behind me because it is, for some reason, it is unbelievably hot. At the end of September, in Seattle, it is crazy hot, so I'm dying right now. So I have my fan on me, so that I don't catch heat stroke, or get heat stroke, I don't, anyways. Now if you guys remember, I did a video just like this a few weeks ago called A Brief History of DC Comics, and I'm gonna give you the same quick disclaimer. This is the entirety of the history of Marvel Comics summed up. It's going to be going by decade. I will be doing 2 to 4 points on the company in each decade. And obviously, so many things happen in 10 years. I'm not going to get every single thing that happens in 10 years. I'm just going to be getting things that I think are interesting and important. If you like this video, if you like this content, if you like this format, please make sure you like and put it down and put a comment down in the comments below and just let me know that you're enjoying this. But yeah, so Marvel started in the 1930s and is still running today. So I'm going to start back in the 1930s and then move on forward. So starting up, we have in the 1930s, Marvel was founded by Martin Goodman in New York City. It was originally called Timely Publications. They published their first comics in October 1939, or that's when it was dated, October 1939, and it was called Marvel Comics No. 1. Marvel Comics No. 1 included the first appearance of their first two characters, the Human Torch and the Submariner. Stan Lee, as we all know and love him, or Stanley Lieber, was hired as just an office hand, actually, in 1939. He was Martin Goodman's cousin, and so it was just kind of like a favor. I have my notes right here. If you're wondering why I keep looking off screen, it's because my notes are right next to me. It'd be cool to have all that memorized, but no. 1940s. Jack Kirby and Joe Simon are some of the first hires for Mr. Goodman, and they create Captain America. Stan Lee, eventually, that year was in the 1940s, 1941, I believe, was made interim comic line editor, a position that he ended up holding for decades, even though it was just supposed to be temporary, so that was pretty cool. And then also, Martin Goodman, he began to publish books under a number of shell companies. Why? That's a much broader subject that I'd love to get into, but just know he started publishing books under Atlas Comics, Marvel Comics, Timely Publications, and so forth. So there's that. Moving into the 1950s. Post-war America fell out of love with superheroes. We all know that from the DC Comics video. So like DC, Marvel had to kind of adapt. So they ended up breaking into comics like Jungle Comics, espionage books, westerns, war comics, etc. Just like DC did. Marvel seemed to have a really good grasp on things such as Monster Comics. Those were really big. DC didn't do Monster Comics as well as Marvel Comics did. They're kind of known for that sort of stuff. And then Timely began to just publish books solely under Atlas Comics for a while. Not indefinitely, just for a time. Also, they attempted and failed to bring back Captain America and Submariner in the 1950s and Human Torch. They actually lost in favor to Western and War Comics. So Western and War Comics actually outsold Captain America, Submariner, and the Human Torch in the 1950s. But then we get to the 1960s, and the 1960s was the biggest time for Marvel, because not only did Stan Lee help create the first superhero team ever, which was the Fantastic Four, but Marvel also saw the release of the Avengers, Iron Man, Hawkeye, you know, Black Widow, Ant-Man, Wasp, Hulk, everybody, X-Men, the list goes on. Scarlet Witch, Quicksilver, Groot, Doctor Strange, literally everybody was like, in the 60s, that's when it all kind of became a thing. The 60s, Marvel brought back the superhero with a vengeance and released all of those characters that we all know and love that are currently in the movies today. So, 60s. Going into the 70s, in 1971, the Department of Health asked Stan Lee to do a comic book story on drugs. So, now if you guys are familiar with comic book history, there's something called the Comics Code Authority, which actually prohibited stories on drugs because of the a public outcry back, you know, a couple of years earlier to the 1970s. You know, there was like a book by Frederick Wortham that was called Seduction of the Innocent. Look it up. But anyways, due to public outcry, comic books started to censor themselves, creating the Comics Code Authority. Now, when the Department of Health asked Stan Lee to do this, he had to do it without the Comics Code Authority, and it was one of the first stories published without the Comics Code Authority seal on the front. So there was that. He did that. It was a Spider-Man story. I can't remember the issue off the top of my head, but in any case, and because of that story, the Comics Code Authority ended up getting revised later that year. Martin Goodman retired 1972, and Stan Lee replaces him as the president and publisher, and then Stan Lee appointed Roy Thomas as the editor-in-chief. Wolverine came out in 1974, and in 1975, Marvel hosts an early version of a Comic-Con called MarvelCon, so it was one of the first comic conventions ever. Not the first, but one of the firsts. So, 1975. Moving into the 80s, Marvel had their amazing run, the Secret Wars, which, you know, was in, I think it started in 1982, and that ended up creating a massive Marvel universe, and then that is where Chris Claremont and John Byrne, their careers really began to gain traction. But aside from Secret Wars and things like the Hulk and things like that, you know, the 80s were relatively quiet, just lots of great stories and collectible books, lots of first appearances. Moving into the 90s, so the 90s was a tough time for the entire comic book industry. We did see almost the entire crash of the industry. Marvel tried to lift itself up by launching the 2099 series. And then they got a devastating blow. They lost Todd McFarlane, Jim Lee, Rob Liefeld, Eric Larson, and a ton of other guys when they left to go start Image Comics. And then here's an interesting thing. So due to the near implosion of the comic book industry, Marvel Entertainment, they filed for Chapter 11 bankruptcy protection, and then they merged with Toy Biz in 1997 to kind of avoid bankruptcy. But they also ended up selling off rights to, you know, Spider-Man for movies and X-Men, things like that, to Sony and Fox. So come 2000, even though they slowly and quietly, like, you know, in the 2000s, they slowly and quietly, like, relaunched some of their comic lines. They opened a couple imprints, such as Max for mature readers and Marvel Knights, among others. And Fox launched the X-Men movies, and Sony launched the Spider-Man movies. Now, if you're as old as I am, which I'm not that old, I'm like 24, but, you know, you would have been a kid right around the time that those Spider-Man and X-Men movies came out, and they were terrible, but as a kid, they were the coolest thing ever, and funny enough, a lot of people really attribute those crappy old Fox and Sony movies, and take when I say crappy with a grain of salt, I still like some of them, but you know, some people attribute that to helping revive the comic book industry because it ushered in a whole new generation of comic book fans. Kids who went out and saw the Spider-Man movie and the X-Men movies wanted to read their comics, so they started flooding local comic book shops. So that was really cool. What else happened in the 2010s? So 2008, the first Iron Man movie comes out, which I guess technically initiated the Marvel Phase 1 movies, and now we're like in Phase 4, and you already know how much money they're making at the box office, so that's awesome. And then here we come to the 2010s. So, you know, the last 7 years, Disney purchased, Disney, back in the 2000s, not 2010s. So back in the 2000s, Disney acquired Marvel Comics for $4.2 billion. That's 2009. And then in 2012, Disney, along with Marvel, because since they owned Marvel, purchased Star Wars and the rights to Star Wars from George Lucas for $4.5 billion. And they then revoked the license to publish Star Wars comics from Dark Horse Comics and gave it to Marvel Comics, thus having Marvel Comics begin to publish Star Wars comics in 2015, I believe. Marvel also, in the 2010s, launched Marvel Now and all new, all different Marvel. And then in recent months, though their movies continue to top the box office, in recent months Marvel has undergone a lot of criticism because of their current content. People are, accusing them of pumping out a quantity of comic books, but not quality comic books. And, they've reported slumps in sales. Now, this is just me reporting to you. That's not my personal opinion. I still love Marvel. I'm a huge fan of Doctor Strange, Ant-Man, and Moon Knight. Those are my big guys right there from Marvel. But unfortunately, yeah, a lot of people are attributing a slump in sales to their over-diversification and poor quality stories that are only, you know, getting high sales on their number ones and then slumping in the next 10 issues, which are then, you know, getting them to end up being canceled, unfortunately. But while that's happening, Marvel movies are, like I said, still topping the box office. So I hope that wasn't too confusing, guys. That was like 80 years of Marvel Comics summed up in about, let's see what my timer says, 10 minutes and 25 seconds. So obviously I didn't catch everything. If you think I missed something that was really important, please put it down in the comments so other people can read it. Maybe I'll put like an annotation or a card or something like that. Again, if you enjoyed this video, like it, share it, tell your friends about it, email me, tell me what you guys would like to see more, hit me up on Facebook, all that stuff, the comics and stuff web or Facebook page. I'll put a link to that in the description below. And that's really it, guys. So thanks for tuning in, and I will see you all next Friday.